rapper Lil Wayne was featured in a remix of Future's Karate Chop, and in the remix, he makes a reference to Emmett Till. Now, Emmett Till was a 14-year-old boy from Chicago who was brutally murdered in 1955. He was tortured and shot in Mississippi in 1955 for whistling at a white woman. Till's family objected to the lyrics that Lil Wayne used in his remix of this song.
Right.
So, just to tell you what the lyrics are. Now again, this is a remix of Future's Karate Chop, and it was leaked online. And the part where Lil Wayne raps, he says the following: "Beat that pussy up like Emmett Till."
Oh.
So, the reason why Emmett Till's family is understandably upset is because he was beaten, he had his eyes gouged out, he was shot in the head, and the people who did this to him tied a cotton gin fan to his body with barbed wire and tossed his body into a river. I mean, it's the most hideous thing you could possibly do to a person, okay? And to make that kind of reference, of course, is devastating to the family of this victim.
1955, first of all, it was not that long ago.
I know.
And his crime, according to those people, was that he whistled at a white woman. 14-year-old boy, okay. So any reference to Emmett Till should be a respectful one in the first place. And I thought maybe, you know, beat someone like Emmett Till, and that's way wrong. But then to add
the visual violence, right? The violence against women, I mean, there's that element of it as well.
And the sexual reference,
yes,
on top. I mean, it's on a scale 1 to 10 on disrespectful, it's at a 11, okay?
Yes.
And so now that I know what the reference is, guilty, crazy, should have never put that in the song.
Now, Epic Records is apologizing for this. They're saying that this unauthorized version of the remix should have never been released on the internet, and they're doing everything that's possible to make sure that they take those lyrics out of the song before they re-release it. So, you know, they're doing what they can to apologize for it. They've contacted Emmett Till's family directly and apologized to them as well. So they're doing what it takes to make things right. But I mean, you gotta have a little more judgment when you're coming up with
your lyrics. Terrible judgment.
Yeah.
And look, here's the thing. Of course, we're a believer in the First Amendment. I don't want to censor the guy, but you hope that you have better sense than that, right? And if you don't, well then, you know, the market should punish you in a sense, but people shouldn't buy that, right?
Yes. So I love that you made that point, because keep in mind, Future is with the Epic Records label, right? But Lil Wayne has his own record label. So if he wants to publish a song where he says stuff like this, he can. And you don't have to worry about any record label trying to censor you. And
right,
then, you know, of course, the free market can decide whether or not they want to buy that kind of music.
I know people, rappers, singers overall, want to push the envelope and they think it's cool, and then you get more marketing hype and there's controversy, etc. But Lil Wayne's supposed to be smart, and this is pretty frickin' dumb.
And that's the thing, he is smart. He definitely pushes the envelope with his lyrics. He does that regularly, but I think that in this particular instance, he went too far.
I'd like to see what he has to say. I think even though they're doing all the backtracking and apologizing, he has to say something.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah, he's got to say
don't
something.
Don't write a statement, don't have your people do whatever. I don't know if he wrote it, someone else wrote it for him. Either way, you have to verbally say something.
So I read more about Emmett Till because I was really fascinated by his story. And his body, even though they tried to sink it to the bottom of the river, it did turn up. And the body was returned to his family. And his mother actually had an open casket funeral. And the reason why she did that is because she wanted those images to be part of the civil rights movement.
Mm.
So if you go online, and of course they're extremely graphic, you could see the pictures of his open casket funeral. And it just shows you, you know, our country's history definitely had very, very dark times.
And that's why a lot of people, like the right wingers, will say, oh, you want to go all the way back to slavery. I don't know, it's not all the way back to slavery. And that was 55, but these kind of murders, lynchings, et cetera, happened through the 60s. And you know, and then you think it was over then? I mean, in terms of intimidation, oppression, et cetera. 60s, man, that, again, that was not that long ago. And a lot of people who were around then are still around now.
Mm-hmm.
Did they all have a Damascus kind of conversion? Or do a lot of them, you know, sit there and think, oh yeah, the good old days. And what do they mean by the good old days?